What is appropriate crosslinking time when performing CHIP? I'm Fang Chen, senior scientist in the CHIP group at Cell Signaling Technology, and this is CST Tech Tips. Crosslinking or fixation is the first step in the CHIP protocol. The purpose of crosslinking is to prevent dissociation of DNA from protein during the 3-day CHIP experiment. Otherwise, the antibody can only put down its target protein but not the DNA at the end. Crosslinking is especially important for transcript factors and cofactors because of their lower abundance and weaker binding with DNA compared to histone proteins. Also, tissue is a more difficult sample type than culture cells, as it's harder for a crosslinker to get into each single cell in tissue sample. Therefore, a longer crosslinker time can be helpful for transcript factors, cofactor, and the tissue materials. However, over-crosslinking leads to difficulties in chromatin sharing, especially when using sonication to fragment chromatin DNA. So we need to find a balance where proteins of interest are firmly fixed with DNA and the chromatin remains shareable. Based on our experience, 10 minutes of crosslinking is enough for cultured cells, no matter what type of target the protein is, histone, transcript factor, or cofactor. For tissue samples, 10 minutes of crosslinking is adequate for histone protein CHIP, but an increased crosslinking time up to 30 minutes might be necessary for transcript factor and cofactor CHIP. I hope you found this video helpful. You can find full protocols for all applications on the specific product page at cellsignal.com. And if you have any questions about an antibody or protocol, you can get in touch with one of our scientists at cellsignal.com/support. For more tech tips videos, subscribe our channel, and we will see you next time. Good luck with your experiments.